One of the most iconic brands in all of motorsports is Porsche. From the 356 to the 911, Porsche has been synonymous with the top level of performance since its inception. Now, over the past few years, Porsche has become one of the hottest brands in all of car culture. And recently, its 991 variant of cars is at the top of everyone's list. In particular, the 991 GT3 RS. Today on the Targa Trophy Ride Check, we're lucky enough to be invited by Rod Emory, legendary old school Porsche builder, to try his 991 GT3 RS and see just how good it really is, and if it really lives up to all the hype centering around this car. This Porsche 991 GT3 is about as perfect as a car is gonna get in today's world. Every aspect of this car is on point, from some of these unique design features that they've plugged into this 911 body, the mechanical upgrades that they included into this RS version, just the overall package. When you're talking about the aesthetics of the outside, that's where Porsche really killed it. Between the wide body, the menacing louvers on the front fenders, the insane 20-21-inch wheel and tire setup, massive wing on the back, and bespoke body setup, this car is just unbeatable. Everything's pretty straightforward in here. This is your quintessential 911 layout. You got the massive tach, you got the speedo, all your fluids and temps gauges that you need to know. This particular version has the nice full carbon fiber package, the coveted lightweight buckets, obviously, and some nice Alcantara options just to round things out. When you stack this car up against the standard GT3, it's a really interesting scenario you're talking about, because essentially, even though when you look at the cars, they look quite a bit different, they're actually not. Talking about a 4-liter engine, standard GT3 at the 3.8-liter. This car's a little bit taller than the standard GT3. Obviously, it's got the wider, beefier stance. But when you drive this car from behind the wheel, on the streets and in the canyons, it's not too far off from your standard GT3. So to really, really feel the difference, odds are you're gonna have to go to a track with a really competent driver to see which one's faster.
Well, don't sweat the technique.
GT3 RS. If you have unlimited budget and you want a car that looks badass, and you're not trying to get all the performance you can out of every dollar, this thing is awesome. Just borderline nuts, insane, super cool looking, awesome to drive, feels great, everything. But the GT3 is all of that as well. And if I'm having a penny pinch, I think I gotta go with that car. And I hate to say that because I love this car, and on its own, it is fantastic. But when you compare it to something like the Super Street Cup, like we did in an early episode, or just the base GT3, I don't know if I could justify this thing. When you compare it on a fact sheet to a base GT3, you're looking at a lot of the same numbers. The weight is essentially the same. The horsepower is only 25 different. It's only got 13 foot-pounds of torque more. Everything about it, like, the numbers are so similar, and when you drive it, you feel that similarity. That said, this thing is incredible on its own. And as you can hear, you still have that incredible noise. The high revs are just incredible. And when you climb, and the speed doesn't matter. As long as you have the RPMs in the right spot, you're like serenaded by Porsche's signature sound, right? It's just incredible. I just don't know. It just doesn't feel different enough to me. And because of that, I'm frustrated because I want to love this car so much more than anything else. And I just can't, because the GT3 does what this thing does for quite a bit less. I don't know. I wish it was just a little more special.
When you're talking about the overall package of this 991 GT3 RS, it is pretty insane. You've got everything you need in a car. You know, Porsche arguably builds one of the most bulletproof cars money can buy. You can beat the living hell out of this car day in, day out, on the street, in the canyons, on the track. You're not gonna have any issues. But the real question is, if you're in the market for a GT3, do you go 3.8 standard version, 3.8 and street cup it, or go whole hog and step into a 4.0 RS? That's a really tough question to answer. Let us know what you would choose in the comments below. So while you guys are making comments, we're gonna keep ripping this RS.